I am Nilesh Mandlecha. I am a psychologist by profession and I have done my MBA in HR. I conduct training program for Indian Army, Indian Navy, Mumbai Police. I have conducted TV programs on more than 10 TV channels. I conduct programs for more than 50 companies for management and non-management. I am a visiting faculty for Management Institute in Mumbai, and from last 15 years I am practicing as a psychologist. Welcome for this talk on how to talk, how to read a person like a book, understanding non-verbal communication, that is on body language. This is very interesting subject. I will start with my presentation. First, I will show you a small video clip and then we will start the presentation.
It's something you've known about and seen, but probably not learnt. It's something we all do automatically, and it speaks far louder than words. In fact, research shows that in only 7% of cases do we rely on words. We depend on inflection and tone, 20 to 30%. But body language does our communicating an amazing 60 to 80% of the time. So, the human animal's movements and gestures can tell one story, while their voice may be telling another. Mind you, it's easy to go overboard and suggest that when someone folds their arms because they're cold, that it's really a barrier to other people. Or that this has a hidden meaning when the person does have an itchy nose. Or that there's a sexual connotation to this when the poor girl is simply making sure her knickers stay up. So it's a mistake to try and interpret a solitary gesture without looking at it in context. For example, this person is probably scratching his head because he has dandruff. Now, it's because of uncertainty or forgetfulness. There are many gestures we make involuntarily, which, when used in groups called clusters, can be a window to our thoughts.
So the first most important thing about understanding body language is the context. Very important. Somebody is shivering, like is doing like this, maybe it's a person, somebody is feeling cold, or it can be also defensive posture, right? So it's important to understand the context and then interpret about body language. Let's see the presentation. Charles Darwin, theory of evolution. He first wrote the book on the expression of emotions in man and animals, and that laid the foundation for this human emotions and the body language. After that, subsequently, many people started studying and understanding this body language. Albert Marbain, he started, you know, what he's saying, 7% of what we say when we communicate. Then 38% from the tone, inflection and speed, and 55% from body language. That much importance he has given. Then further also one more professor studied in this area. Verbal communication is saying 35% important, non-verbal communication over 65%. This is what all about. This is a study. But now important, it is used in films also. Like specially silent movies and Charlie Chaplin's movie, the non-verbal communication and the body language is very widely used, emphasis is being placed on these things. Whatever I am going to say is not the last word on the body language, understand, nor does it contain any magic formula promised, you know, whatever I am going to say, it's not like a magic, right? Studies and research from, I am going to share studies and research from sociology, anthropology, zoology, education, psychiatry, family counseling, professional negotiating and selling skills. One more thing we have to understand when we talk about body language, that cultural differences in US, India, China, so that also influence to certain extent body language. Declaration, images are taken from various books. Dr. Alan Pease from Australia, mainly I have taken material from his books on body language, and these images here are used for non-commercial purpose. What is the purpose of today's session? To get greater insight into our communication, to develop understanding of other people and self, to make you more aware of your own non-verbal cues and signals, and to demonstrate how people communicate with each other using this medium. Understanding how something works makes living with it easier, whereas lack of understanding and ignorance promote fear and suspicion and make us more critical of others. One example I would like to share here. A bird watcher does not study birds so that he can shoot them down and keep them as a trophies. So our purpose of understanding is developing better understanding of relationship and understanding human being. That is the purpose. The purpose is not the manipulation or something else, right? These are very familiar signs, right? In WhatsApp or the Facebook, these are very familiar signs. You can see smiling face with open eyes, the first one, right? And different. Which one? Can
the
you?
Middle one from the second last row.
Second last row. This
middle
one.
Middle one. No.
Yeah. Yeah. You can.
Middle one. Second last row. This one.
Huh.
This one has been included by Oxford Dictionary as word of the year.
Okay. Word of the year.
Word of
yeah.
Laugh out loud. Or
yes.
Tears of joy. It's the word. Every year they incorporate one word which they say has been used very extensively.
Okay.
But this is the first time an emoji.
Yes. So these, you know, different meaning. This shows anger, this shows fear or terribilizing, crying. So this shows, you know, that it's very testy, something like that. So it is being used widely by the people. See, I'm not going into detail because we have to talk. See, everything has got a meaning, right? Whatever, you know, it's coming on WhatsApp or Facebook. So people are using that. That is quite common. Now I will hand over the presentation to Pragna. She will continue from here. Pragna, you can introduce yourself.
I'm Pragna Mandlecha. Well, myself, I'm Pragna Mandlecha. I'm a B pharmacist and MBA marketing. Last 15 years, I'm in the working in a pharma company and corporates, and I've dealt with various people at various levels. While talking to subordinates, while talking to colleagues, while talking to the bosses, and we have observed various body languages, and this is the medium which communicates or transmits message which has not been spoken, and this is something which is very interesting, and it is something which is not new to us. Just because body language is a subject and it's a matter of, like, you know, people's interest to understand what do you mean by body language and what we can understand from the body language. Why am I saying that, like, it is not such a new subject? Reason behind it, we can see that, like, you know, millions years ago, our ancestor used to use this non-verbal communication when there was no discovery of language. How they used to communicate? They used to communicate with effectively the fearful expression, effectively. I need something, desire, want, anger, frustration, irritation, then attacks. They used to non-verbally, they used to communicate. So this is something which is not a new thing, and it is in our genes itself to communicate non-verbally. In modern era itself, if we can see a child, when his stomach or his tummy is full, what he does? He just nods his head saying that I'm full. Nobody has taught him. But like that instinct itself, inborn instinct itself has been, like, you know, made him to say that, like, no. At the time of teething time, it starts grabbing everything and anything, let it be that finger of mother, father, friends, or on his. But what is his doing it? He's attacking. That is a teething. So that attacking itself is getting expressed over here. Common thing, the shoulder shrug, which is very common, universally very well accepted, that thing, something which I don't know. It's shrug, common shrug. Certain common things, yes, universally accepted, thumbs up. All the best, great, good going, victory, V for victory. Certain things we keep on using in day-to-day our life. Certain interesting thing to understand a behavior of a man when we go in the crowded place, what we do it? We just become like a robotic person. We fold our arms and do not move much, either walk straight or look down. Automatically, somewhere it is unwritten rule type. The moment we go in crowded place, that like we are not permitted to speak anyone. You must avoid the eye contact with the others. You are maintain a poker face. Okay? So no expression at all to each other. If you have a book or a newspaper, what do you do it? You forcibly you put your head into the newspaper or the book, showing that, pretending that you are engrossed into the reading. These are something which is unwritten rules, which all of us at times do such kind of a movement. In elevators, you are compelled to watch the floor numbers above your head. The moment you are in elevator, what do? You do not have any other option but to look at the floor numbers. So that means body language is nothing but it is a type of tip of the iceberg. Tip of the iceberg, that means its address, appearance, voice, body language, behavior, etiquette. But below that, there is a stronger and a deeper version of your values, beliefs, your USPs, motivators, drivers, standards, strengths that get reflects automatically. What you are thinking subconscious mindly, the same thing, brain gives instruction to our different body parts and automatically it happens without your notice. So this is something which, that's the reason body language is something which is the tip of iceberg.
The way body language comes from subconscious mind.
It's a subconscious mind, that means whatever you are thinking, it's reflecting, because the maximum information you know about your brain, what you are thinking and all, we will come to know as we take few more examples. Probably I'll be able to answer this question. Okay, just wait for, if you do not get the answer, we'll come back again. Now, a simple thing probably everybody would like to know, to observe who is lying. Yeah, everybody's favorite thing, who is lying, we would like to know. In case of children, whenever they lie, automatically what happens? They cover their mouth and they know they are lying it, because brain has given the information that you're saying something but you're lying. So this is our natural instinct, natural reflection, that brain gives the instruction to cover your mouth because you're lying. And poor child cannot manipulate that at that age, you know. So here it is about the child. The moment we get into teenage, we start manipulating things, and here it is at the time of a manipulation, what we do it here also, instruction is to cover your mouth, but in a sophisticated way. How do we cover your mouth? Yes, because brain has given instruction but you have lied. In case of adult, further it is more sophistication, that is here it is instructs his hands to cover his mouth in an attempt to block the deceitful words, but the last moment the hand is pulled away from the face and a touch, nose touch gesture appears or result. Okay, now this is about how you can identify who is lying, what distance signifies,
and one more thing, yeah. Lying, the tone jyada bad jata hai thoda sab koi, and eye contact avoid karta hai,
yeah,
aur mere ko pasina bhi aane lagta
hai. Yes, pasina, especially near eyebrows, you will get that, because your body, we have those symptoms, immediately adrenal start rushing in, and because of that sweating, then constriction, clench, eye pupil contracts, so these are the symptoms where you can make out that person is lying. Especially that person will avoid eye to eye contact.
Eye contact
Yeah, one more thing, if you're talking really a truth or something from the heart, automatically hand will go like this. Right? The hand will go like this. So that means the person is talking within or truth. Most likely. Yeah,
when you speak truth, there's a confidence, you know.
Yes, there's a confidence. There are simple things, you know, I will share right now. See, when in clinical setting, when people are coming for counseling and I'm sitting like this here, right? Whatever I'm talking, suppose the person is interested, the person will come automatically looking forward. If whatever I'm talking, not interested, and then like will go behind. Or, you know, the indication will come here, the slight stress will be shown over here. And in one of my training program recently, what I have done, I asked people, I said, whatever I have spoken now, I'm going to call anybody, and that person has to speak for 5 minutes. The moment I said, and the expression of the face has changed, some people, you know, started off avoiding eye contact. So these are very visible signs people, you know, give when they are communicating non-verbally. They are not directly telling something. If somebody is in controlling mode, the controlling parent, you know, immediately, you know, the controlling is the signal like this when the person will talk. So there are different gestures. One lady came to me for a counseling, and during the counseling process, she was about to say something, but immediately lips. These are the lip movement. So what does that indicate? Something is trying to come out, but she is stopping herself in between, right? So then I understood that, and I told her that one part wants to tell something, but other part of your mind is having objection. So I made that part relax. Then she said after that she was having, she was being abused as a child. So that can be very important information, especially in a counseling setting, right? So now I will again, Pradnya will continue.
So main is the eye contact when you lose.
Yes, you have many various examples. Okay, we have images where you can clearly, you can make out like what has happened actually. If anybody is lying it, or anybody wants to withhold some information with them. So as we'll proceed, you'll get to see all the images, right? Now, what distance signifies? See, everybody has its own territory. It is not only a human, but animal also have their own territory. We live in our own territory. However, I'm standing over here, I consider that, like, you know, the nearby space up to this distance is mine. Okay, I would not allow anybody to come or encroach in that area. So whenever we move around, what do? This is mine. We not only occupy our body structures, but at the same time we also have the right to have the space in the air. So what is that all about? So this is just an example that animal also, they set the, like, you know, define their territory by urinating and saying that this area is mine, do not allow to enter anybody else. Similarly, in human state also, there is a condition that is one, which is an intimate zone. It is somewhere it is 15 to 46 centimeter. Then we have personal zone, 46 to 1.2 meter, social zone, 1.2 meter to 3.6, and public zone, that is above 3.6 meter. Now here it is intimate zone, where you only allow your, with whom you have an emotion, maybe your partner, maybe your parents, okay, where you have some emotional bondages, in that intimate zone you allow any second person to enter in. Say here it is, it's not that only with people with whom you are emotionally bond, like they can enter. In this particular case, you can see this man is at the comfortable position, but he has entered in the intimate zone of that woman. Now, in this particular case, he is trying to take a sexual advance. So in this case, if she leans back, that means it is not acceptable.
accepted.
And she accepts, that means it is opportunity for a man to move forward. So we use this kind of a body language or emotional signals whether to go ahead or step back. Okay? In case if somebody is refusing, if somebody is annoyed, if somebody is entered in their intimate zone or trying to disrupt, in that case the heart pumps faster. In that case, adrenaline pours into the bloodstream and blood is pumped to the brain, and the muscle as a physical preparation for a possible is ready for fight or flight. You know that situation.
And
so
she's trying to go this side, you know, like not, and you see this person is trying to enter in her
intimate zone. This is something is an acceptable conversational distance. Something which is 46 centimeter and not showing any of the signals of personal intimation. Okay, so it is conversational acceptable distance. Now let us move on to the personal, but something which is casual, whether where at the time of, like, you know, gatherings, functions, we see it that, like, you know, fine, distance is 18 inch to 4 feet. Social zone, it is somewhere between up to 3.6 meter. Okay, social zone means nothing but whenever you have anybody, a plumber, carpenter, like, you know, who is entering in your house, postman, and you maintain a distance because he has come to repair, you do not go so close to him. So that is nothing but it's a social distance. You maintain that social distance. Public zone, you are a speaker, audience, so you have ways to make a distance between with our audience.
And one more research. It's the more the distance is, lesser the distance, at least. But it's not just not like this, you know, it's not like this. But, you know, the appropriate distance, that also there is one research in environmental psychology with respect to distance. So it's important to understand. So what this, if this zone is disturbed, like on the table also sometime, if table is there, you know, half this portion is yours, half the portion is yours. And deliberately if you try to put something, you know, in their zone, they will again push back that particular thing again into your zone. So
especially in movie seats, you know, the other guy also wants to
be at
the armrest. It's always
yes.
I have that problem. It is not comfortable to sit
like
that.
Yeah, so they
feel like what is exactly
they have
a common
like the
chair.
Armrest is common, no?
Yes.
Now this is about, like, you know, how much distance and what distance signifies to us. Another important thing, like, you know, your palm also transmits some or the other message. And what is that message palm gesture transmits to us? The palm facing up is used as a submissive, okay, as a submissive, non-threatening. And at the same time, it's a suggestive of pleading.
Pleading.
Suppose if you get caught in front of the policeman, don't book me, please. Yeah? So this is the message. Immediately you become a submissive and put your palms. You do not say, hey, no, don't charge me. Because you are at the sub. Immediately your body will, structure will show that submissive.
Or you don't hold the hands up, you know, awesome.
The hands up, yes.
Surrender.
Show the gun.
That, yes, in fact, ancestors used to do this.
Even
at the time of a greeting, and if it is two communities, they are coming in front of each other, suddenly they used to make their hands up, saying that I do not have any weapon to attack you, so you please, like, you know, feel we are friendly. So this was a non-verbal communication at the time of, like, you know, our ancestors. When the palm is turned to face down, you will have a immediate authority. That whatever I say, that is right. You can clearly see from this posture. Downward facing conveys the dominant and control. Look, this is the way you are supposed to do, and this is the standard operating procedure, and you become immediately you become a authoritative.
My word is final.
Yes, my word is final. That's true. Okay. So this also transmit a message. Yes. Often we use this word, this point. Better you don't do this. So again, it shows that aggression, palm position, right? Here it is. At the time of like, you know, many times open. Open, that means honest. Like person is honest and trustworthy, because standing and with a open arms. With this kind of a posture. Say in case of this particular image, open arms can indicate like elegance and submission. Okay? Yes. Now this is something which we need to observe. That whenever we keep our palms behind and we hide them, or we put it in our pocket at the time, that means it is a clear indication that we are hiding something. In case of child is lying or concealing something, his palms are hidden behind his back. Husband who wants to conceal his whereabouts after a night out with the boys will often hide his palms in his pockets or in an arm fold position, just to not to reveal that where he was and what was he doing here. Right? So, if the person is holding back.
The mistake in the sentence, because you say with the boys, it could be
anybody. It can be any gentleman. That's why initially, as I said, the first video what I have shown you, where it may be because of dandruff or it may be because of something, right? So, context is very important, right? Very true. It,
So that is why I also felt this should have some other meaning also.
Yeah. See, this can be like this also, the authoritative meaning as well.
Hmm.
But child, suppose, like you understand, the child's gestures can be like this, right? So it depends, it's very important to see the context. Before we jump down to the conclusion, we can form hypothesis after observing body language. We don't jump down to the conclusion.
Yeah.
So we need to observe and then we can jump down to the conclusion. Right? Very important.
So sometimes when I'm teaching, when some student says something, so I also do this, but I am not hiding anything.
Correct.
But I'm just trying
it
to.
It can be authoritative. Yeah. It can be authoritative gesture. Yes.
This is something which is one can observe for himself or herself. You know.
Mm.
If at all, for any some reason, if you are at all manipulating, you know, just for a experimental point of view, what do you do it? It's not always to observe the other person to find that like whether he is lying or not, or whether he is hiding or not. But many of the time, a natural, what is our reflection? That is also important to...
From there also we can learn
a lot. We can learn a lot.
And suppose, if I am cold, I can also put my, you know... And so, context is very important, and we can form hypothesis. If we observe ourselves, you know, we can also learn more about body language, our own body language, right?
So, here it is. Now, this particular is, like just now we said that it's an open position, honest position, trustworthy position. In fact, in sales department, they have been taught that sales people are often taught to look for the customer's exposed palms. Customer's exposed palm at the time of a briefing or at the time of a selling of his or her own product. Whether that buyer is ready to purchase or not ready to purchase. If he is open, his body language would be leaning little ahead. Open palms will be open and he is trying to buy the product. Okay, so from that point salesman will get an hint whether this person is going to purchase or not. Forward facing palms serve to push the problem away. It's all yours.
Stop.
It's all yours. That's not none of my view. It's all yours.
Stop.
Right? No. The closed palm pointed, we have seen the aggressive upright posture, open arms and genuine smile convey ease and confidence. Okay. Very upright position, ease and confident you can make out. You can see hands are little up. That means she is drawing the audiences. Okay, welcome, come, come. No? Throw your ideas. So that time, like, you don't say throw your ideas. That time, let the ideas flow in. Yeah? Now, understanding the importance of palm. That open palm means honesty and trustworthy. So, understanding the meaning of the body language, can we use this body language to manipulate? What do you mean by that? Is it possible to fake your own body language? Suppose if I want to lie and at the same time smartly I use this body language, and will I be able to fake a person or make a statement? Answer is no. And however, I'll show the open palm. However, I try to be a confident, but there are certain micro signals which are all the parts of the body reflex, and because of the lack of congruence that is likely to occur in the use of the main gesture, the body micro signals and the spoken word. For example, open palms are associated with honesty, but when faker holds his palms out and smiles at you as he tells a lie, his micro gestures give him away. That means your pupil will get contract. Some of them will avoid the eye contact. So some or the other way that person will get caught, that person is probably
sometimes film like those who are working in the film or the serials actor, sometimes they may manipulate. Right. Because we are not actors, right? But in their case, but still the body will give you the signal. But sometimes some people may get into that.
Yeah. See, in case of police interrogation, especially policemen, what they do is they put a focus or flash on the face so that they can capture all those micro signals of the person to understand whether that person is really lying or is honest. Now coming to after this palm gesture, coming to the greeting gesture, can that transmit some of the message for us? Yes. Three basic attitudes transmit through handshake. One is dominance, second submission, and third is equality. Taking the control, allow other person to feel that he is in command of the situation. I'll just show you. Now, okay, he's a submissive and I'm taking a control. That means my position palm is
up
and his position is submissive. That means I am taking the control and I'm showing the dominance. In this condition, palm of gesture to show the submission to other. That means, okay, fine. Oh, hello. So what happens? This become a, that means I have ready to obey your command, right? So I go in submissive mode, right? Third, it is shake like man. So no bend, nothing. It is straight and right, upright.
Ma'am, what about if the fingers are just coming in and you are just holding the fingers and the person?
Yeah, that move. Also it is there. I'll show you. Okay. Shall we go step by step?
Yeah.
Okay. It's over there. Now, how to turn down the dominant handshake? Now you have understood. I am there to dominantly show my attitude. So, how to counteract that? Interesting. If somebody is presented with dominant handshake, it is take the handshake and step forward on the left floor and go in the right step. Okay? Hold the hand. Just stand up. Okay? Right? Give me the, like that. Getting, so you brought him to equality. So this particular method is known as step up right. Let's go to the left, right, go to the cross, be at with that angle, take it so that he has to move his hand from like this to straight, and probably you can cover it with the other hand. That means it's not that up or down, it is straight and on the equality basis. Understood, no, this is?
Yes.
Yeah. Palm down thrust, the most aggressive handshake style dominant male who always initiates it, with a stiff arm and with the palm facing directly downwards forces the receiver into the submissive position. That means strength. That means no scope but to you to act as in a submissive handshake. Ekdam strict and at the same time. So the next person do not get chance only to do the step up position or try to make him right. Okay, so it's a very aggressive dominant handshake. How to counter down this palm down thrust? I mean it is a bit difficult, but somebody is doing it. And then that hand, literally you have to shake it wrist. Put it your hand on top and like this. Okay? So you have to grab it, but you have to understand this. Who is the aggressive, dominant, showing attitude and doing a handshake and how to counteract that. The glove handshake, usually this is politicians. So this is, alright, give me a vote.
Both okay? Are politicians.
So that means, yeah. Immediately somebody is meeting you and like you know doing a glove handshake, that means he wants something from you. He is not a trustworthy or honest, but he wants something from you. Dead fish, everybody is aware of it.
Cold.
As in just for the sake of do not have energy. And many people they give such kind of a handshake when they do not have any like as if they do not have any material inside.
And many people are afraid of sanitation also, you know.
Yeah.
When they do that like that, they are very reluctant to shake.
Hands.
So it's a very kind of reluctant,
correct.
Hesitatingly.
Right.
They are people that you don't touch them.
That is also there. The stiff arm thrust, where you can like, you know, you give it from the distance. Okay. This other person is trying to, but he is, no. So that shows that he is not interested. Okay. So to keep you at the distance and out of the initiator's intimate zone. That means I am not that much interested to greet you. Here it is, what question you have asked, that like to keep the receiver at a comfortable special distance, okay fine. Not so much interested and here it is. The wrist hold, the elbow grasp, this shows the sincerity, trust or depth of feeling towards the person. If somebody is shaking hand and also holding the wrist like you know, then it shows that like you know, I have emotions for you. Sincerity,
people
okay.
Die, yeah.
Yeah,
especially the
especially
old people, you know, they do that still like this.
Correct.
Holding your this or this.
Wrist hand or the elbow. Right? The upper arm grip, the shoulder hold. All this show the like, you know,
yeah.
I have emotions for like upper arm. Yeah,
yeah,
I do
also.
Well.
Yeah, like this.
Correct. Here it is, intimacy and control increases the left hand. You can see at the time of shaking hand, at the same time, upper arm has been gripped. So what is that? Like, I care for you, you know, and I have emotions for you. But in this case, the way he is wrapping him up, what is it showing? Yes, he's showing his power and he wants to take charge and the control here.
Yeah.
No?
Yeah, by the way, your hand is very soft.
Hand to face.
This gesture.
Yeah, hand to face gesture. Here it is, as we have discussed at the beginning itself, if somebody is covering, that means that person is lying and the brain subconsciously instructs it to try and suppress the distressful words that are being said. We already discussed. Here one more point I would like to highlight. Whenever the nose touch happens, okay, lying causes the delicate nerve endings to tingle. That happens naturally. You observe when you are lying, it automatically there tingle, you know, and to satisfy that tingling, we touch our nose. So this is what it is scientifically also proven, that like there is a correlation between your body reflection and what you are thinking in brain.
Sometimes ear also, no?
Like yes, so, yes, we have that image as well. Okay, now here it is, many times at the time of a line, not only touching nose but at the same time rubbing eyes. Again it's a tingling. But why, what has been said over here? Wise money says, says see no evil. That means he knows that like he's lying, but at the same time he cannot see to avoid the eye contact of the other person. What that person does? He will look down and rub it up. Yeah? Again, suppose it refers to a gesture cluster of clenched teeth. He is doing this, but at the same time, clenched teeth and false smile. The eye rub gesture and averted gaze, this also portray that like, you know, gesture is used to, by movie actors to portray the insincerity, but is rarely seen in real life. Most of the times all wheelers, you see in the movie, how they portray themselves with a rubbing eye, clenched teeth and at the same time a plastic smile on the face. Yes,
yes.
At the time of like, you know, many times here, what does this say? An attempt by the listener to hear no evil in trying to block the words by putting the hand around or over the ear. Okay, so this is also another example when person is lying, and this, there are several variations. Ear rub gesture include rubbing the back of the ear, not only the ear, but rubbing the back of the ear, the finger drill inside, up and down, finger drill. It's screwed back and forth inside the ear, pulling at the earlobe or bending the entire ear forward to cover the ear hole. This gesture is a signal that the person has heard enough or may want to speak. That means it's not only a scratching, but at the same time, what do we do it? We pull your ear. If somebody is talking too much, and now you want to say that now enough, yeah, now it's my time to say, come on, yeah, it's too much to hear from you. So that time, however, we do not verbalize all those things, but you, your body automatically communicate to the other person. This gesture is a signal of doubt or uncertainty. What you are saying, I am not agreeing into it. Now I verbalize that, but most of the times when I do not verbalize, what do you do it? I am not in sync with what you are saying. Okay? So this means that he has doubt. There you can ask a question. Do you think that like, you know, you want more explanation on this? You know, that's the time you can poke in and make that person understand, if at all you're a salesman or you want to convince a customer. Now another commonly used body language, you're talking and the next person, if you can see it, pulls the collar. Why that? Again, it reveals that a tingling sensation, a delicate facial neck tissues and a rub or scratch was required to satisfy, and because of that, it's a tingling sensation that person gets. So when a person is feeling angry or frustrated, needs to pull the collar away from his neck in an attempt to let the cool air circulate around it. Now so much boss is talking and you are angry and frustrated, but you cannot say anything. So what will you do it right in there? So, okay, fine, let me pull my collar and give little circulation to that part, because I am frustrated, I am angry. Automatically that tingling sensation, I am going to get it. Okay? Here, the fingers in mouth gesture is an outward manifestation of an inner need for reassurance. These kind of people, they want reassurance, security, safety, you know, that is their need from within. And to satisfy that need from within, what they reflect? okay? Or suppose if you have a pen, or if somebody is wearing a specs, what will they do it? So they want more assurance before purchasing anything. I'm not satisfied with all the benefits of this product. I need something more, okay? Okay, somebody is holding a cigar pipe, so that cigar pipe will be in his or her mouth. If it is child or teenage, reassurance. Finger we will put in mouth, okay? So this is reassurance meaning. Now there is also a certain thing, cheek and chin gestures reveals. What is that? When the listener begins to use his hand to support his head, it is signal that boredom has set in. Okay? So when you support your head, that means boredom is set in. This automatically body takes the step, because otherwise you will fall, slip. So to prevent that, you give a support to your head. Okay? Now person begin to lose interest. See, here it is, we are very smart. Now I do not want to show that, like, you know, I am getting bored. My boss is in front and he is explaining me that, like, this is going to be your target and this is going to be the, like, you know, work you will be doing for a week. And he is then, and I am at the same time, I have to respect his words. I have to show that, like, I am interested what you are talking. So wisely, what am I doing it? I am showing it. However, I am losing my interest, but I am pretending, I am showing it, yes, I am interested in it. So this is something which is interested evaluation. Okay, and when the index finger points vertically up the cheek and thumb supports the chin, the listener is having a negative or critical. In his mind, some of the negative and critical thing is happening. Ki kya bol rahe hai, ye toh mereko bhi malum hai. ये क्या चीज नया तो पढ़ा रहे हैं, यू नो. सो दिस इज, यू कैन नॉट मोबिलाइज दैट, बट ऑल द नेगेटिव्स आर ऑलरेडी देयर इन हिज माइंड एंड आईज. जेन्युइन इंटरेस्ट इज नॉट ओनली, इज नॉट सपोर्टिंग. जेन्युइन इंटरेस्ट इज दिस हेड स्ट्रेट, ओके फाइन, आई एम इंटरेस्टेड, ओके हैंड्स ऑन चिक. Stroking chin, that also suggests something. What is that? The chin stroking gesture is a signal that listener is making a decision. Now time to make certain decision. If, for example, the chin stroking gesture is followed by a crossed arms and legs, the buyer sits back in his chair and the salesperson has been told that I am not interested. That means sit back, I'm not interested, okay? Suppose if it is, answer is going to be yes, in that case his body will be more open and at the same time chin will be, he's stroking, he's in the decision making, but body is quite open, so that salesman can ask him, like, where should I make it available, how is going to be the payment, is you are going to make it, such kind of a conversation he can proceed. Variation of decision making gestures. Someone who wears the glasses often follows the evaluation cluster by removing them and putting one arm of the, already we have discussed, that is if somebody is wearing glasses and he can, instead of chin stroking, that person can put that thing in mouth, okay. Evaluation decision cluster, the evaluation gesture moved to the chin and hand may also be stroking the chin. The person is evaluating the proposition while making the decision. If it is by doing it here, it is on the cheek as well as you are stroking the chin as well. So you are making the, you are thinking about the proposition, whether to make it, whether to say yes or no. Now here it is, when you are holding a chin and you are supporting your head with the help of thumb, that means I am not interested, please complete this as fast as possible. Yeah? So evaluation with the head supported by the thumb is the listener because I'm interested. Head rubbing and head slapping gestures. A person who uses this when lying usually avoids your gaze and looks down. This gesture is also used as a signal of frustration and anger. In a group, if you can, people are standing and one person is talking about, "Arey, maine ye kiya, maine wo kiya, main yahan gaya, wahan gaya." Automatically, our hands, "Mere ko jaane ko nahi, kya paka rahe, sunna pad raha hai iska." Automatically, you start rubbing.
That's why it is called pain,
pain
in the neck.
We
say actually, there, when there is no pain, still people say there is a pain in neck.
Now, such people are more difficult to handle, those who are doing like this, okay. But if it is, in case of like, you know, if something head slapping gesture, those who are habitually rub their foreheads to non-verbalize in error, if that is in subordinate has done something mistake and boss says like, did this, still it is better because their boss is more open to say upfrontly that you have done this mistake and done this error than a boss who is doing like this. So, ठीक है अभी तो देख लूँगा बाद में तेरा अभी जब marks देने का time आ जाएगा तब मैं देख लूँगा, you know. So, this is much better than that of folding arms. This is a standard arm cross. It's almost, most of the times it reflects that something is holding back and I'm not ready to open my inner self. And I want to hide some or the other information, or maybe a defensive position, or maybe a negative attitude. But probably that could be because of weather as well. Okay, we have seen that beginning itself. In this case, when it shows a hostile attitude with a grumpy face, and at the same time, fist is closed and tight, that means I am having some or the other negative thinking and I am annoyed. The hands are tightly gripping the upper arms to reinforce the position and to stop any attempt to unfold the arms and expose the body. Okay, so this kind of a body posture, it's almost, it is gripping tightly to the arms, you know. A person who is going to do an operation, doctor who is going to do an operation for the first time, that time probably that nervousness, a person who is ready for that paragliding for the first time, and that time his postures will be like this and ready, unfold it, okay. This shows the superior attitude where your thumbs are up. Okay, woman showing a displeasure. Standing posture also communicate to us some or the other thing. It's a defensive standing position where you're crossing your legs, at the same time you're folding your arms. Close body and close attitude, both the man, they are like communicating, but with the close attitude and close body, because you can see the body structure is cross leg and at the same time fold arms.
I will share something. Before I got engaged to her, I first time went to see her, and her brother first time, you know, he never saw me, so his first, you know, the language, the body language was like this. And when I started talking after some time, it becomes like that. So it is very, that means he is not aware who I am, what I am doing, who are you, why you are here. So
he was on guard.
Yeah, he was on a guard.
Yeah.
But after talking, you know,
the guard, he let down his guard.
Yeah.
In fact, we had one patient who had come for the counseling just before marriage. Both of them had come to him, and I was observing whenever he used to ask a question to her, she used to look down and she used to blink her eyes, think a few seconds and then reply. So this one was going on and I felt like as if there's some problem in her eyes. Why is she so blinking fast? Why is she blinking fast, you know? And it went for a quite long period of time. And the moment he was counseling her fiance, so by that time she was with me and outside. Okay, and that time when I was conversing with her, she was quite relaxed and she was not at all blinking, you know. So I saw that like drastic change, and I felt like, was she the one who was like, you know, replying similar, because she didn't want to reveal herself, you know. So because of that, she was blinking her eyes fast, she was nervous, and maybe like later on to
win. Yeah, one more thing this related to this. One parents, they came with along with her, their daughter, for a counseling. In the first setting, they were talking about their problem. Then I said, you will have to also get involved in the counseling process. I will counsel to your daughter as well. So I finished two session. After that, I finished two session with their daughter, and then I told them, now parents go to our gulabari. दोनों पेरेंट्स आए ना पहले तेरा रवि हमारी इधर कुछ तो भी करेगा मतलब थेरेपिस्ट विल डू समथिंग एंड समथिंग वी विल द पेरेंट्स यू नो ये भी बताएगा अभी कि व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मिस्टेक वी आर डूइंग सो फर्स्ट ऑफ देम सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सो आई मेड देम फर्स्ट रिलैक्स एंड देन यू नो द काउंसलिंग प्रोसेस स्टार्टेड फॉर दैट दिस इज वेरी ऑब्वियस दिस डिफेंसिव हैंडशेक या
हियर इट इज यू कैन मेक आउट open body and open attitude. A body is forward and erect posture reveals the aggression. Now this is the precision grip, demonstrates exactness. This shows that exactness, you know. This power grip demonstrates with the conviction and determination. Most of the times the leader, when they speak it with the conviction, they speak. The chopping gesture demonstrates it's a clear conviction. If you happen like this, it will does like this. So it will give the clear conviction.
Stiffly.
The lower stiffen indicates a listening attitude. Whenever like you joint your finger and those are open, that means you are open for ideas. It's not that like, you know, you are only the authority person to take a yes, you are open to listen. And if it is downwards, so you are accepting the ideas from the other person.
And this is, you know, that it can show the confidence as well. This stippling, this can show the confidence when you are talking, right?
Straddle stance strongly conveys the message to dominate and power. Okay. Here it is sign of uncertainty and submission. Sideways glance with a smile shows
interest.
Sideways glance away from you can indicate a lack of interest. Whenever somebody touched to the heart and tilted head, the open smile indicates the appreciation, or whatever I'm saying it from the bottom of the heart. Okay. So we can trust that like whatever you're saying is true. The finger over the mouth and the scissored legs indicate she is holding back. She is not ready to reveal her inner self. Arrogance can be conveyed by the head tilt and jaw thrust. You can always find many people with the nose up, and that shows that like arrogance.
Marathi is saying is, Marathi is saying is Naku.
I've seen people like, you know, in someone, one of our relative is like that, so arrogance, you know. So
it's not really, you will find many people,
but very close relative of us, you know, that arrogance, that means I'm something, you know, you're not. So that kind of a thing. Yeah.
A forward tilting forehead implies a critical attitude. Genuine smile pulls back both the mouth and the eye, so it shows the genuine smile. A fearful person, one can make out, okay, something is wrong with that person. It is very common, just like a thumbs up and victory. Smiling with tight lips. Now, this is something which one can minutely observe. Smiling with tight lips means that you aren't going to be a sharing your
thought.
This is something which is probably people fail to understand many of the times. The turn away smile elicits feeling of the care and protection. is neutral head position. Interested position, okay, fine, I am interested. Depressed posture and collapses in on itself. Disapproval position. Maybe somebody, you will be as smart as I am to show that attitude.
And this, if suppose this posture, I have got my video on body language. If the other person is doing this posture in that video, that you know the person whom you are, that person also taken this posture. So this person felt little uncomfortable, and when I came back to normal.
Right. So
yeah,
you are breaking the norm over there. So here it is. I am just as smart as you are. You are trying to say that you are not the only smart guy.
I also
can be a smart guy, and there game gets collapsed. Okay. Because it's a matter of, at the time of conversation, it is also important that how you are equally communicating, not only verbally, but through your body language. Ready for action. Hands on the hips, probably they are trying to expose their clothing, you know, most of the times. Yeah. Ready to proceed. If somebody, yeah, I want to show that. Ready to proceed. Yeah. Readiness to end an encounter or conversation, hands on. If somebody wants to finish the things and wants to get up, he will get up like this.
But you want to go, like.
Yeah, he wants to proceed. But in this particular case, now encountering is something different where your hands will be on the knees. And I finish my, and that's my done. And my deal is over.
10 yeah? days back, I conducted program for Department of Post. And the program was up to 7 o'clock. It was at 6:30. From 6:30, I found two ladies. They were, you know, they were like in a little position, like they were trying to do. And then I asked, "What? No, no, my child is at home. Please let me go fast." So that's the. They were, you know, all the time like, you know, trying.
Restless.
Yeah, restless, and they were trying to. You know, the position was like that, but they were not able to sit.
On your mark, get set, leaning forward, gripping the chair, that means you are ready to get out of this chair. Again, here it is a sexually aggressive female, you can make out. Now, when at the time of sitting in the corner position, diffuses the tension and promotes a positive attitude. Whenever it is 45 degree angle and conversing, that diffuses the tension. And the moment, if it is a table, rectangular table, and put placing, you are sitting at the center place, and if somebody is sitting this side, that shows the commanding position. But here it is, I am trying to negotiate, I am open to learn, I am open to give ideas, and I am ready for the sharing. That indicates when you are sitting at the corner. The 45 degree angle encourages relaxed, informal and open communication. Pointing your body directly towards someone indicates you mean a business. Gesture showing a pride of ownership. Person is standing for a car, ownership
bike.
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 Claiming ownership of the desk. Okay. Lack of concern. How casual is sitting? So which shows that I'm least bothered and lack of concern. Thinking alike, carbon copies and mirror images. This you can see it. Many of the time you'll see in corporate parties, isme hum log bolte ki boss is always right type to present and to pretend that, like, you know, they'll try to do the mirroring images. But all the time they will toss the glass also in the same fashion.
See, if there are many times, sometimes these some salesmen, they use this. They try to mirror
the
customer.
Yeah, that to influence, like,
copying the other person gesture to gain
acceptance.
Body lowering and status, your highness.
Your highness,
giving more importance to the next person. Okay, open triangular position signaling acceptance. All the three people are, like, in a triangular place and they are open for each other's, and showing that, like, you know, acceptance of all the three people. In this particular image, you just observe this woman, she wants to leave while the man wants to hold her attention. Okay. this little bit, yeah, she wants to move on, she wants to go, she wants to leave, but he wants to hold her. Now in this particular posture, the moment she folds her hand, what you can imagine, strictly she wants to say, no, I'm not interested, I'm not committing to you, and, but still aggressively he is trying to make his efforts. So this is what it is, body language is expressing over here. Common critical evaluation cluster, sitting in the group, making some or the other presentation, but some people will be like, you know, critical evaluation, they will keep on doing it. These two men are telling us they are disagreeing about something, clearly it is reflecting with the folding up on the body of facial expression and at the same time a placement of palm. Right? So, thank you very much. If you have any questions, please ask.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.